Good afternoon. Welcome to Music Scrap, the Musical Scrapper. And I am here just a couple of minutes late. I was up wheezing, not wheeling. I was up wheezing and coughing most of the night. Silly asthma. So I'm kind of sniffly and as usual. All right, I've got to try and figure out which way is going to be best for me to have my colors here. I guess this way. All right, I've got my watercolor sketchbook, which I have hardly used, but I figure I'm gonna do some practicing. Oh yeah, that was right ugly. These were using those pens that spread. Hey Jillian. Hey Juju. Somehow I missed you on the list. Hello, hello. Okay. See, that's the problem with this book. Gets in the way of my paints. Well, unless I do it like this. I think I can see all my colors good enough if I do it like this. Hey, Ella! Hello, hello! So, I'm sorry, to those of you who are watching the recording on YouTube, this is being recorded live on ustream.tv/channel/musicscrap, MUSICSCRP, and I am going to do some practice watercoloring today. Bye, bye, Pat. All right, so, oh no, the chat is split again. Well, if you're not seeing the right chat, folks, keep refreshing the chat. Pop it out, close it, and then restore our social stream until you find us. All right, so now all right, I got to open my photos because I've got some photos saved here that I want to paint or practice. So I've got lots of things here I want to practice. Maybe I'll start with this flower. I guess that's a pretty good look at the color. Hey, Dr. Dot! Hello, hello, hello! I do have perfect pearls and stuff, Eileen, but for today I'm going to practice some, well, as traditional watercolor as I can get. So we got some lemon yellow. I'm going to need my orange. So better spritz my colors here. These are Winsor & Newton Cotman tubes that have been spritzed in. Except for the indigo. The indigo was a free tube of Mission Gold that came with my palette. Because, of course, my palette is Magello Mission Gold. Muse! That's a good one! Eileen, she goes, for those of you watching the recording, Muesli goes, honestly, you jump into chat, the first person you see is Eileen. She's like water. She gets everywhere. Good one. Yeah, she could have said worse, Eileen, for sure. All right, so I guess I need to draw my flower. Haha. Well, let's see. I think I'm going to this over here where I can see it. All right, I'm gonna start. Oh, I did start recording. Never mind. No, Eileen, I got the word no down pat. I won't disconnect you. I just use the word no. Not happening. All right, so that's way too. One moment, please. Need to find my eraser back here. And I know it's here somewhere. Hello, hello. Oh, sure. Now I find my glue stick. Of course, it's almost gone. So, I did need some anyway. Okay. That's nice. Find my eraser. Oh, here it is. No, that's not it. Alright. Too long. Janet! Woohoo! Welcome back! Hello, hello. Glad to have you here. Sorry I didn't get to your stream, but by the time I woke up, I had to get my water. I'm not very good at drawing, so. Someone sent me a message on Facebook. I'll have to lighten some of those lines because some of them are too dark. That's the lead. Hey Barb! Welcome, welcome! Oh yeah, the zigs. Diane, you got the zigs, did ya? Aren't they wonderful? They are amazing! All right, and then on each petal, okay, so I'm actually gonna, this is not a landscape, so technically I can work on it this way, which is good. All right, so I'm going to start I don't know if you guys can see that sketch at all. I think you can. Yeah, you can a little bit. Okay. So once again, here's the image reference photo. This is from Pixabay, I believe. So I'm just trying to see. All right. So I'm going to start with a yellow wash. My number 12 round. Hey, Joan. Ah. All right. So this is a Canson watercolor journal. All right, so let's do the flower here. It's cold press paper. Try not to wet the background for now, just the leaves, or petals, I mean. So this is in my watercolor journal, so considering this practice, because I need tons of practice my watercolor technique, of course. Oh, shoot. I don't think I can get it over the whole thing here. Nah, it's not big enough. But it is, I guess it should be alright, I guess. It's kind of poofing on me. Time I get this wet, the other leaves are going to be dry. Taking a little too long to get around with the water. That's a eyesight thing. I like painting wet and wet. I know it's not always the technique needed, but for my wash, that's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna have to go over these a second time because it's all dry and soaked in now. I'm using my nice color water dispenser that Mac bought me. All right, so I need some lemon yellow. So I've done some research for my artist quality paints that I want to buy. Tax refund time. I always get mine done at the end of May, or end of February, I mean, so my refund usually comes by the end of the first week of March or so. Usually takes a week, week and a half. All right, here we go. And I have decided, I think, on the M-Graham paints after a fair amount of research this weekend. Wow, Jen. Geesh, at last. Though it just got stuck on the bottom of a pile at customs, I guess, eh? Someone just decided to let it sit there. Sometimes I swear, the more you call and ask where it is, the more they're going to let it sit there just to show you for complaining. All right. Yeah, Muse, I know, eh? Hey, Leah! Nice to see you. And if I missed anyone else, hello, hello. And this is not a tutorial, folks, because I'm learning. So please don't think of it as a tutorial. Thank you. You're just watching me practice painting. And all right, first layer. Hey, Kathy B! Hello, hello! Alright, so that is my first layer, my first wash. So I need to dry that. My heat gun here. Oh, all twisted up in wires, oh dear. Okay. These are Winsor & Newton Potman, yes. If that's what someone was asking. So these are the student grade Winsor & Newton Potman tubes that I've put out in my pan to allow dry. I have to add a little wee bit of red to that orange for the center part. I think my center's too large. Hey, Kathy! Oh, thanks, Anonymous. Who's an on? Who's an on? 7048. Thank you, thank you. Whoever you are. I'm just going to spritz a little bit of water right here on my on the actual palette. So when I get some water there, it'll flow, or paint there, it'll flow a little better. All right. Probably shouldn't, but I'm going to move down to my smaller. I know, you're supposed to use the largest brush you can, but I'm not comfortable using my large brushes yet. Alright. Because my second wash of yellow. And after all my research of the professional watercolors, I have noticed something that they keep talking about, and that's about the actual ability of the paint to re-wet itself. And I'm going to go into my, I think it's, no, not the new gamboge. I don't think it is the, yeah, the darker ones. I don't know where my, I'm going to go into my, I've got some green in it, so I'm just trying to get the green out of my yellow there. Go into my warm yellow just a little bit and add some of that in places as well. Okay. So, my second layer is wet on dry. Let's see how well it glazes. Remember if I said hello to CB yet, but anyway, hello, hello. I do think I need some of the new gamboge, but I'll go back in with that later. Sorry, it's hard to keep up with chat and watercolor because you have to move. Fast. Okay, Muse, no problem. Alright, so I am going to go for a little new gamboge, because I think it needs a little, needs a little dark in there. I think that's what I want. I'm just going to put it down here. Yeah, I think that's what I want. But it doesn't need much. Finer brush. Huh. That's more what I want, so I'm gonna try take some of that away. This one should be almost dry. Okay, so I just need to have it a little more. Yeah. I know. All right. Let's see here. Oh, hold on. Too much water here. Don't need my puddles. Get rid of those puddles. Thirsty brush. Going with my trying to learn to regulate my water, especially with these new brushes, because they hold so much more pigment and water than cheapo brushes. Vicky, I'm practicing some watercolor techniques. This is my reference photo. Some kind of daisy. I don't know flowers. I don't know plants. It's a daisy of some kind. No idea what kind. So right now I'm trying to add a little color and a little texture. To the yellow areas. Thanks, Ella. Thanks, Vicky. You know, try to right, bye, Juju. See you later. All right. So I'm adding. I'm using all three of my yellows here on this. My lemon yellow. I can't remember what my warm yellow is. Plus this new gamboge, which is also a warm yellow. These are the Winsor & Newton Cotman, so they're student grade, but from tube, not from the pans. I squeeze them out into my palette, but they were from the tubes. But I know one thing they talk about with the M. Graham compared to the Winsor & Newton Professional and the Core, actually, is that the M. Grahams are so much easier to activate in your palette and etc. And not to mention their wonderful environmental aspects of how they make their paints and etc. So I'm just trying to add a little texture into there. All right, so now I'm going to go back in. I need to add some of this. Oh, but I have to hold on. See that? And these dry very quickly on your palette, too. Even with all the water I had in that, it's dry. That puddle of lemon yellow I had dried very quickly there on my palette. But that's because it is a student grade, so they tend to... Alright, and then I'm going to go in with some... new gamboge to try and add a little texture in there. All right. Hey, Mildred. Okay, so orange. Alrighty. And I need to get some of my this red. Like, I don't know what I did with my... Oh, sorry, you can't see. Okay, and if you hear that, that is my water well refilling. All right, so I'm going to do my next layer of orange there, and then go in and add a little bit of that warm red. Then I'm going to... All right, I need to cut a part of my card off here and keep it in my... So I'm going to cut part of my scraper card here and keep it in my palette. Just adding some texture into the petal. And I'll hold it up there so you can see a little better. So, same on each petal here. Revamp the orange. A little red. Warm red. And some texture. I'm trying to make the lines go with the shape of the petal. So not making them straight, I'm curving them. Guys, Diane, I'm not paying attention. Was there something important? Thanks, Diane. All right, bye, CB.
Oops. Sorry, I just noticed some puddles. Small puddles, but still. Stop going back. You can always do it in another layer. Jeez Louise. Uh-oh. What am I doing? Oh, mess that up. Change. So, messed it up. Gonna have to lift it and fix it. Lift it and fix it later. Dang it. Oh! I see. Eileen was afraid you guys were ignoring me. Oh, well. That's different then. Obviously. Okay, I'm gonna have to let that dry and come back and try and repair that messy leaf. Let it dry and come back to it. I keep forgetting about how much water my brush holds, so that's what messed up that last leaf. Petal, I should say. It's not a leaf, it's a petal. Petal. Stop trying to fix it, Jean. You're just gonna make it worse. That guy didn't go down. Okay. So, let's keep going around here. See, and that's part of the problem with these Cottman is that some of them lift so well when you try and do this next layer of glazing, your other layers pull up and it's a pain. I want to be able to add layers. Thank you, Joan. Hey, Carrie. Nice to see you. Yeah, if I can bring this, it'll be a miracle if I can bring that petal back to life. Yeesh. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Try and soften that edge a little bit. Okay. All right. I have to do some Lindsay the Frugal Crafter paint alongs. I have to do some where I paint along with her because I love her paint. I don't paint quite as loosely as she does, but I do like her painting style. I love her teaching style. She's a very good teacher. She doesn't just, you know, sit there and do her thing and think she's teaching. She actually explains why she does certain things. All right. So, after I pick up my color, I'm going over to my towel here, and I'm rubbing just the ferrule and just the bottom of the brushes to make sure there's not too much water in there and there's nothing that's going to drip onto my painting while I'm working. Just help control my water flow. So when you do these scrapes when the paint is wet, the paint will follow the scrape line, so your dark color will fill in on those scrape lines. Bye, Sophia! Thanks for coming! Kathy, you don't have to. That's what I said. I said, this is not a tutorial. Not everyone who streams does tutorials. That's not what I meant. I don't consider myself doing a tutorial or teaching anything today. I'm just painting. Some people color and just come to stream to spend time online while they're coloring, and that's completely allowed. I didn't mean that at all. Please don't think I meant that. Hazy! That's not what I meant. I was just saying that she does tutorials, and they actually are tutorials because she does, you know, teach her technique out there, you know, while she's working. Not everyone has to do that just because you stream. I need a little bit more the dark in there of the red. A little more of the red. That one too.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay. Hey, Rebecca! Welcome, welcome. True, Diane. We do all learn how to shop from each other. That's for sure.
All right. Here we go. Still have to do my dark layer here on each petal. Two dark layers, actually. One's kind of a olive green, and then there's a brown layer. So I do have to get this reddish orange far enough up. Okay. And scrape. Doesn't matter, Kathy. If you don't know, you don't know. Someone in the chat will know the answer. That's the thing when you're streaming live and someone has a question. If you don't know the answer, someone like Eileen will have the answer for you. That's what's nice about having the live chat and not just doing a YouTube video, because there's someone out there. There's someone there who can help you answer questions. Water at the top there just to feather it out a little bit. And
Yeah. Windsor Newton Cotman from the tube. Yes, I love watercolor. Kathy. I don't think I'm as good yet at doing watercolor stuff as I am necessarily acrylic. But I don't know, there's just something, it's strange. I mean, why would a person who is such a total control freak like watercolors? I don't have a clue. Can't answer that question. Because it seems weird. I've always loved watercolor, even from as a young kid. I wanted watercolor lessons. Mom couldn't find us watercolor lessons, so she found an art teacher that did charcoal and oil pastel. Hey, King! Darla, nice to see you. Well, yes, Dorothy, you can control watercolors, yes. But there is somewhat of a more kind of... I shouldn't have done that. Got my fingerprint in it. I was doing so well, too. All right. All right, almost done. One more, and then I get to try and fix the messed up one. Ow. Ah, I see. Thanks, Mary. Welcome, welcome. Thanks, Dorothy. All right, so let's try this one. Let's fix it. Let's see. Not too much water, Jean.
And although I need water here, there we go. It might work. It might work. So I found a series last night. It's being carried on our CBC network, our Canadian CBC network. But it's a British show called The A Word, and it's about a family who are dealing with the fact that their 5-year-old is on the autism spectrum, so he has ASD. Okay. So, that's good so far. Dry it, heat gun, and pull off. Yeah, Kathy, I agree. And Lindsay the Frugal Crafter does quite a few real-time painting videos, and they're great. Joan, yeah, I did manage to fix that leaf, that petal, I should say. So now I need to make a nice olive green. Yes, Barb, I know she streams at, isn't it 12:30 Eastern she streams? Lindsay the Frugal Crafter streams live on YouTube at 12:30 Eastern, I believe. And she does do some other live, occasionally does another live stream on her own without her niece Sarah there to help read questions. She has done some other live ones. All right, so let me see. All right, I still need a little more texture in that center part. I don't think it needs to be maybe a little bit of the olive once I get it mixed. All right, so let me see here. I need oh no, I really messed up one of my yellows. That's really messed up. Okay, hold on. I think I need to use this green. Hold on. I need my bigger brush. All Sorry, I wish I could tell you the colors I'm using, but I don't know why my color chart's not in my... And I just don't know my colors well enough yet. Oops. Umber make a nice olivey color. Alright. Maybe a little bit more green back in with that. There we go. That looks good. So that looks like a good color match. Alrighty. So here I go. Hey, Eileen. Okay, Orla, hugs. Yeah, Debbie's streaming tonight in place of Ella. All right, so okay, that brush is holding too much water. Gotta go back to my smaller one. See, it's lifting up my layers underneath, which I don't really want, but I do want that line, so that's gonna work. That's okay. Oh, wait now. What's Xander saying? Oh, yay! 3 o'clock. Xander's going to stream tomorrow at 3 to show Happy Mail. I have Happy Mail sitting at the stupid postal outlet. Oh, I'm so mad at our post office. I got the tag on my door on Friday morning. So I assumed at the end of the day on Friday, when they finished their runs, they would drop off the packages at the postal outlet, and I would be able to pick it up today on my way home from my appointment. Now, I'm really glad my driver, they don't have to do this because it's, you know, an extra drive. It's disability transit. She was kind enough. She had a few extra minutes, so she waited for me to go in and pick up my package. And they're like, oh no, it's not going to be here until today at 1. We didn't get our deliveries yet. And I'm like, you mean it stayed on the freaking truck all weekend? Why didn't he drop it off at the end of his shift? It makes no sense. So it's still sitting there until I can get a ride back over again. Thank goodness I didn't pay a cab to go and get it. It does say on the package, today at 1, but I assumed it would have been like Saturday at 1. Makes me very angry. Stupid! So, anyway, Joan, I'm pretty sure your package has arrived. It's just sitting at the postal outlet. It is. Remember, we have a huge country, more land space than you guys, and only 1/10 of the population. So it's a much more expensive, you know, to run any kind of business that involves, you know, land and transportation. Just because we don't have the population to use the service, yet we have all this land space that has to be covered. It's a real pain. But anyway, I'm just glad I didn't pay. I know, Eileen. They look like candy corn, Eileen says. And yes, I'm not doing a lot of... I'm leaving lines at the top of these because there are lines at the top of these in the photo. And now I need a darker, so I am going to add some more and add a little bit of red to it to give me an almost black. So I need a little more green. I don't need much of this black color. It's just... bit of black, green, a little bit of burnt umber, and then I'm going to add a little wee bit of red. To darken it up a little more. A little bit too. Darn. I may have to add some blue, and I don't want to add blue because I'm not going to use blue anywhere else in the photo. So, alright, I'm going to have to stick with that dark brown. Alright. Okay, I'm going to go in with a little Payne's Gray. There we go. That'll work. That's what I want. Yeah, it is a little more brown than I wanted. I may have it's because of the orange, because it's transparent. The orange is turning the green brown, so I'm gonna have to add another layer of green. You have to remember that when you're. I mean, the orange is showing through on the petals in the reference photo. But it's showing through too much in my. So I'm going to dry. And I'm going to add another layer of green. A little bit more green to. Okay, so heat gun! I'm getting hungry. Hungry, hungry, hungry. Oh, right. Supposed to be having a games night. My cousin's tonight. Oh, I forgot about that. Dang it. We'll see. We'll see. If they start without me, because they were going to start at 7, I don't finish until 8. All right, so let's see if I can get another layer of green in here. The thing with this well is that all the dirty water doesn't come out, so you don't really get completely clean water each time. All right, so... I need a little more green. And I think I'm going to use just the green without the burnt umber added. For this top layer, and hopefully it'll kind of green up a little bit. Oh, way too much water, Jean. Ooh. It lifts up the layers underneath. That's why I don't like these paints. That's why I did research on my other ones, because if I had done the research, I would have known that these Cottmans do that.
your dinner. He's gone. Oh, Jen is shopping. Okay. That helped some. It brought out the green a little more. I can't really do too much more because it's gonna come. All right. So I'm trying to get, see how that is in the center? I'm gonna have to leave the petals at that, I think, because if I try and work it too much, the layers that are down are going to come up. But I do need to work on the center a little bit more. So I need some orange here. And then I need a couple of dabs of red, I think, just to add some texture. Going in with a little more thick of this, I don't know what color it is. Might even be yellow ochre. Calling it New Gamboge, but I can't remember what it is. Thank you, Diane. All right. So, now I guess it's time for the background. So, for the background, I want to use mostly greens, I guess.
Guess green's around, and then I can go to oranges. And some reds. At the outside. Okay. Let's have to be careful of the green and the orange. Thanks, Dorothy. Welcome back. Jen. Didn't do much shopping. You weren't gone for long. I'm trying to get the water clean, but it's kind of hard. It starts filling up before all the dirty water's gone. Okay. So... I'm gonna have to be careful. I should have done the background first. I switch to my larger brush to wet over here. As you can see, my water's dirty. So is my paintbrush, obviously. Make sure all the green was out of my brush before I Alright, so I'm gonna try. Let's see here. I got some different colors of green. So I'm not actually trying to do leaves. I'm just trying to do essence of leaves. Get some color in behind. Right, so I think I can do kind of like this side and then move on. Because it's kind of divided enough, I think. I'm just going to drop in some of the darker mix here. Eileen, Jen's looking for you. She's wondering where our elf went. Oh, finally got the sticker off my brush. That took a little while. All right, so that's pretty good. This part started to dry, so I need to wet it so my paint flows a little better. Of course, if this had been Lindsay painting, she'd have had this done probably in like 15 minutes, but I don't quite have the comfort with the technique to do that yet. Oh, dang it. Little too much water there. So I'm just going to be careful where I put that green. Alright. And hope it's still wet enough to go in with some brown here and there. Then, oh no, gotta go to yellow first and then to orange. So I have to go to yellow first. Alright, did you guys lose me or something? I seem to be getting tweeted at. Hey, Sue! Thank you, Vicky. Then I'm going to just add some dots of just kind of let it flow. Alright, so now I just want, I'll dry that. I want a little definition around the petals. Thanks. Thanks, Eileen. True, Susan. True. Eileen must have had to go and make supper. I think she had to go make some supper. Alright, so now I'm going to do a little shading around the petals just so they stand out a little bit, and I'm just going to use straight into the burnt umber. And then, whoa, fade it out a little. Soften the edge, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to soften the edge like I want. These techniques are hard to do with this paint because it lifts up the layers underneath. Doesn't allow you to do these nice details. So that's another reason I really want my artist quality paint, so I can start practicing these kinds of techniques, the details. I will still, don't worry, I will use these paints. I will use them in coloring books and other pages, but if I want to be able to work on some of these other techniques, I'm going to need my good watercolors. Hey, Timmy! Trying to do it with a pretty dry brush so that I get a good whoops. Would help if I had paint on my brush, wouldn't it? Debbie, wait a minute, you don't like those Mozart ones, Eileen? Is that what you're saying? Kind of missing the chat because I'm paying attention to my paint here. They're full of pigment? Oh, good. That's good to know. So she says they're full of pigment, the Mozart. I don't want it to look outlined necessarily. I don't want it to look like a pen and ink drawing. I do want to define the leaves a little bit, or petals, I mean. But she says the zigs are better. Well, you know, most often you get what you pay for, but are they a good alternative if people can't afford the zigs? I mean, that's an important question. Are they a good alternative if people can't afford the zigs? Yay, Barb! Good! Woohoo! Eileen's like our crash test dummy of art supplies. Oh, Eileen says yes, they are a good alternative if you can't afford the zigs. Lots of pigment, but she likes the brush tips on the zigs better. But that they are a very good alternative. So that's the Moz Arts. M-O-Z-A-R-T-S. Brush, watercolor, markers. Yes, so how long they will last, that's important to know, because if they're more than half the price and they only last half the length of time as Zigs, then they're not really cost effective, except that you don't have to dish out as much money at once, which for some people is important. Zig Clear, they're watercolor brush tip markers. I've got some here. Anonymous. They are these. They've got a beautiful, fine brush tip, and it's watercolor in a marker. And this is the tip is actually a real brush, just like the tip of this is a brush. So these are brushes and they have watercolor in them. I guess I could have used one of those to go around the edges, couldn't I? Never thought of it until just now, but too late now because I'm using my got good. I'm liking how it's turning out here, so. Well, the art bars are not ink tents. The art bars are watercolor. Thanks, Vicky. Just trying to make them pop a little bit.
Thanks, Diane.
One more petal here to do, I think. Too much water.
Okay, not too bad. Not too bad. What I would love to do is once I get my professional set, or yeah, artist quality set, is I would love to do the same flower and see how it changed. Oh, poor Vicky. Thank you, Vicky, with the Y. All right. So unless Debbie is ready to go, I need to get something to eat. I don't know if I have another. Oh, I should date this, shouldn't I? Oh, Debbie, so you're ready to take over? Woohoo! Debbie is ready to take over. Go for it, Debbie. I'm just gonna put the date on this. And you are more than welcome to take over the crowd. Put in your link so everyone can find you if there's a few new people in the crowd here. So they may want to find you. If I can find my memento marker here. This will work. So it is the 30th of January. Thanks, everyone. In the center? Yeah. It does need it, Dorothy. I was just scared to go in with it. Ah, you're making me. All right, so I'm going to go in with a more. All right, Dorothy.
I'm gonna try. I'm using very little water and just green. I guess I need to go around the center too, don't I? With that dark, I think that'll help too. Let me go around the center with some of my burnt umber here and a dry brush. Okay, thank you. No, well, it's not a black center, Eileen, in the photo. See? It's orange. But maybe it just needs a little, whoa, too much water. Just need some of that brown, the burnt umber, I should say. What do you think? Does that help? I think that helps. Thank you, Joan. Thanks, Carrie. Thanks, everyone. If you watch the recording, thanks so much. Lots of work to do, lots of practicing, but you know.